स्टार्ट
आई कैन हियर यू।
बिकॉज इफ इट इम्प्रूव्स वी विल कनेक्ट बैक। तो जयश्री मैडम
श्योर
प्लीज गो हेड एंड स्टार्ट मैडम बिकॉज ऑलरेडी 5 मिनट्स लेट। या
श्योर। सो हाय एवरीवन, इट्स सो गुड टू सी यू ऑल ऑन अ इवनिंग एट दिस टाइम। एंड सो एज यू ऑल नो, टुडे वी आर हियर टू स्पीक अबाउट इम्यूनिटी। And I'm Anita. I'm a holistic and Ayurvedic nutritionist. I'm a health and wellness coach. I help busy people make lifestyle modifications for a healthy living. So the topic for today is probably the most searched topic in the last 2 months, at least. And immunity has become such a big word now that everybody wants to know everything about it. So if you all can hear me and see me, please type yes in the comment box so I know we are on the same page. Okay, that's wonderful. All right, great. So what exactly is this immunity? You know, we've been hearing and, you know, searching it so much. So what exactly is immunity? Immunity is nothing but just the ability of our body to fight some external infections or external agents that come into our body, or even some internal toxins that are getting produced by our body. It's a very simple way of our body trying to fight out what it is not its own. So it, in simple terms, is just trying to fight what is foreign to us. That's about immunity, right? But there are different types of immunity that a person has. In broad sense, we classify it as three main types of immunity. One is called the innate immunity, which is something that we are born with, okay, like our skin. You know, this is something that we are born with. It's the first line of defense for our body. So this is something that we are born with. It's a part of the innate immunity. The next kind of immunity is the adaptive immunity. Now, adaptive immunity can be based on the place that you live in, the kind of infections that you have come across through your life, right? So for example, somebody who gets a chickenpox when they are really young, those people develop an immunity towards the chickenpox virus. So even at a later stage in life, when they contract chickenpox again, it doesn't infect them that much. So that's called adaptive immunity. So we all go through this adaptive immunity throughout our lives. Okay. Then the last and final form of immunity is called the passive immunity. Now, this is something to do with children, especially because as kids are born, the first line of defense for them comes from the mother's milk. So it has been inherited to them through external source into their body in the direct form of antibodies. There is the body doesn't produce antibodies on its own, but it's given externally to the child. So that's called passive immunity. These are three broad classifications of immunity, generally based on the place that you stay in and the kind of environment that you have brought up with. Most of us have immunity towards a lot of things, you know, which we have contracted at different points of time in life. And that is how we have built our immune system stronger. Okay. So what exactly does this immune system consist of? We know immunity is, you know, fighting against the external organisms or external pathogens. But what exactly does the immune system consist of? The immune system is a broad network of cells, proteins, nerves, blood. A lot of things compose the immune system. And one of the main, all I can say around 70% of our immune system comes from our digestive system. So whenever we talk about immune system, it is impossible to forget our digestive system, because digestion is the main process in which all the good nutrients that we give our body gets digested in a, or broken down in a form which our body can absorb and start utilizing it. So 70% of our immunity starts in our digestive system. A good digestive system is equal to a very good immunity in simple terms. Okay, so for example, like I said about the chickenpox, what happens is when we contract any kind of a virus, there's something called B lymphocytes that the body produces, which fights these organisms. And then there is a memory created saying this kind of a virus, if it comes, this is the antibody that I have to produce to kill that virus. So these memory cells get built over a period of time. So every time there is an infection, our body tries to identify this virus with already stored antibodies in it. So the first thing is it'll go search, saying, do I have this? It's like how your computer searches for a file in a database with just the name given. Like that, it goes and searches for this antibody, saying, have I ever, received this in the past? Do I know this disease? Can I like fight it out? Is the first kind of defense. But what happens with cold and flu? You know, most people contract cold and flu every season. Why is it that happens? Does anyone of you have an idea? If yes, type yes. If no, type no. On the comment box. So I know that you're still okay. Okay, some of you know, some of you don't know. Okay, let me just give you a brief view on that. So every season, there is a change in the kind of virus and bacteria, because like us who want to adapt to the new situations, they are also, willing to adapt to new situations. They also want to, manipulate, and they also want to manipulate their genetics so that they can survive in a host body. So they keep playing around and they try to make genetic modifications. So that is why every time we contract a virus or a bacteria, it seems new to our body and it has to produce a new set of antigens and antibodies. That is why every season most people tend to fall sick. Now, there are people who will tell you that if you tend to fall sick, then your immune system is weak, and if you don't fall sick at all, then your immune system is great. But let me tell you, that's not true. If your immune system is reacting, it is great. But if it is overreacting, now that's bad. Okay, so how do we differentiate? First of all, why should we build immunity? Even before going on how to differentiate, why should we build immunity? We should, today's day and age, the situation has come wherein we don't know what kind of virus we are going to get attracted in life, and we can't always keep sitting down in the lockdown. We tomorrow have to go out and do our work or whatever that we are doing. Our children have to go back to school, people have to go back to work, and others who are doing their businesses, etc., have to go back to whatever they were doing. So building immunity before you go out in the world where the chances of infection is always there, it is better that we equip ourselves so that we can deal with it in a much better way, I would say. Okay, so if you're catching a cold and cough like 2 to 3 times in a year and you're able to recover within 5 to 6 days, then you know that your immune system is doing good. But in case you're catching cold more than 5 times in a year and your recovery time is over 15 to 16 days or maybe even 20 days, then it is time that you know what your immune system is going through. You know that your immune system is not in a great place. So let's find out how many of you people have not had infections in the last 3 months, 6 months, never ever. Just type in the comment box, like 1, 2 in a year or 3 in a year. How many in a year? Let me see for some answers. 2. Okay. 1 to 2 in a year. That's great. Once. Since 1 year, nothing. Okay. Okay. Pretty much everyone seems to have a good immune system here. That's nice. So what are the signs, like I said, to know that your immune system is weak? One is frequent cough and cold, like you contract a cough, cold and fever like every time, maybe, once a month or 2 months once, which is more frequent than what it should be. And otherwise, you have frequent tummy troubles like constipation or diarrhea or gastric issues or indigestion, or you eat something and then you have, upset stomach mostly. So your digestive system kind of immediately responds to every food that you tend to eat. So such sensitive, can you mute yourself? Thank you. So, in case you have a digestive system which is highly sensitive towards food that you...
Yeah, we can hear you. Hello. Hello, Jayashree madam. Are you there? Yeah.
Okay, let's continue. So, I was saying that in case you have a very sensitive digestive system wherein it reacts to a lot of food that you tend to eat, then maybe you should check on how your immunity is going to be in the long run. May not be today, but maybe 2-3 years down the lane, you might have issues with your immune system. Then the other way to check is if your wound healing is slow, like you had a paper cut or something, but it didn't heal for almost 7-8 days, then you know the new skin is not come, then it's something that you'll have to check on if your immune system is actually reacting or not. And final one way of finding out is if you're feeling tired mostly. You wake up in the morning, you feel tired. You're working, you feel tired. In the evening, you feel tired. When you go to bed in the night, you feel tired. So there's tiredness constantly. Now, tiredness could have multiple other reasons as well, but one of the major reasons is your immunity being low. So how many of you can say that I feel tired mostly? Can you just type in the comment box? Okay. Okay, others don't feel tired, I guess. All right, so let's move on. What are the few ways that we can boost our immune system, right? So when we talk about boosting our immune system, there are four major things that we got to remember about health overall. The first is the food that we eat, or the diet and nutrition part. The second is the exercise that we do. And the third is the sleep. How good are we sleeping? And the last and final one is how well we are dealing with life or dealing with stress. Okay, so the first and foremost, I would say in this would be, apart from the diet and nutrition, the second important factor is sleep. So we'll start with sleep first. So how many of you get a good night's sleep? Say 6 hours at least. Eight hours is wonderful. Six hours, okay. Unable to hear. Can you all hear me? Okay. Okay.
Anita, I can hear you.
Okay. I just saw Arvind message unable to hear you, so.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Now it's fine.
Great. So 6 hours, 6 to 7 hours of good sleep is very important for all of us. And when we wake up in the morning, we should feel energetic and fresh. So how many of you wake up like with super energy in the morning? Like, I'm ready to take on this day. You can type yes energy or no energy. Yes energy, okay. That's nice. Okay, great. So almost everyone is like super energetic in the morning here. It's good to see that. Right. So what happens in sleep is the food that we eat, the best of the best foods that we consume, it goes and digests, and then the energy is released and all the vitamins and minerals are broken down. So when we sleep, the body utilizes all this breakdown that has happened throughout the day, and it builds new cells for us. So when it builds new cells, the idea of the body is the rest of the functioning should have, kind of slowed down, and only then it will start building new cells. So when this happens, automatically your immune system starts improving over a period of time. So the second most important part of having a good immune system is sleep. The next part of that is exercise. Now, exercise shouldn't be a punishment that you're giving yourself because you had that burger yesterday or something else day before yesterday or a bite of sweet that you had, and that is why you're doing that extra run today. It shouldn't be for that. You're exercising because you want to make your body feel good, or it is more about feeling good about yourself. So how many of you exercise at least 45 minutes on a regular basis? How many ever minutes? 30 minutes, okay. Two hours. Okay, 60 to 90 minutes. Okay. Okay, wonderful. So a lot of people are doing a lot of exercise as well. So what happens during exercise is doing physical home at work can be treated as exercise. If you're doing jhadu pocha and all of that, yes, I would consider that exercise. Standing and cooking for more than 2 hours is considered exercise in a continuous basis is considered exercise as well. But if you're bending and doing, those are the activities that gives the body the maximum metabolism buildup. So doing a constructive activity for 45 minutes at a stretch and not more than that will help your body in terms of reducing its cortisol levels, produce more serotonin and dopamines, which are like the happy hormones for the body, which help in building up new cells in the body. So when we structure our exercise that way, it really helps. When you're doing walking, and you can add up some yoga into that for flexibility and your muscle strengthening, it'll really help. Just by walking, you're only doing the lower part of the body. You're exercising only the lower part of the body. The upper part of the body is not actually doing much of an activity when you walk. So preferably you can add up some 20 or 25 minutes of yoga, basic stretches like a Surya Namaskar or anything like that, that will really help. Maybe like 5 rounds of Surya Namaskar. For a beginner, you can start with 3 and then you can slowly move up to 5, and a maximum of 15 is good enough. Okay, so that will really help in terms of building flexibility to your muscles. It'll keep you younger throughout your life. Okay, so these are certain things that you can add up. The next thing would be minimizing stress. Now, stress is something that is unavoidable in life. We all go through different kinds of stress in life, maybe emotional stress, circumstantial stress, physical stress, different kinds of stresses that our body goes through. And the innate nature of the body is to produce cortisol the minute we are under stress. Why that happens is when we were hunter-gatherers, the point was if they would see an animal, the initial reaction would be fright or flight, So that is how our genetics have been. So today, though it is not a physical animal that we see and we are scared, it is more of the invisible stress that we come across, And this is more bad than the visible stress, because the animal would come, we would probably hide somewhere, and then the stress would go away after some time. But this invisible stress that we carry is there throughout the day for most people. And some people carry it over for many days or months together, which is actually causing more unwanted repercussions in the body than giving you a solution out of it. So what are the things that you can do for stress? The first and foremost, I would say, is meditation. If you have not already started meditating, this is the best time that you start meditating. How many of you meditate at least 15 minutes a day? Or any time frame, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever that time frame is. 30 minutes. That's nice. 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Okay. So quite a few of you meditate on a regular basis, which is nice. Those of you who don't meditate as yet. Okay. Those of you who don't meditate as yet, for them, one simple technique, even if you don't want to meditate or you find meditation very, very hard to do, you can follow the 4-7-8 breathing. It doesn't require any kind of, concentration, or you don't have to really put in a lot of effort to get your mind under control and things like that, which is what people think about meditation. But then this is one very, very simple technique. Sit in a chair, you know, in a straight position, or, you know, you can sit down as well, or you can lie down as well, whichever position. There's no restriction on this. If you are about to sleep, then lying down and doing it is best, because you'll tend to doze off. If you're doing it in the morning, then you might take a power nap of 10 minutes when you do this. So breathe in for 4 seconds, hold for 7 seconds, breathe out for 8 seconds. When you do this, maybe 10 or 15 cycles at a stretch, the oxygen carrying capacity of your lungs improve. Once your oxygen carrying capacity improves, the blood cells that carry this oxygen take better nutrients along with them. When they take better nutrient, better absorption happens, and better absorption is equal to better new cells, which is equal to a better new immunity. So that is how the cyclic process works. And it also helps reduce your cortisol levels in the body. So that is one. The second thing is yoga is another way that you can deal with stress better. The yoga is the sink of your mind and body and your soul, all three together. And it is one of the best ways to find peace with yourself, with the external environment. And I think even if you do Surya Namaskar 15 times, you know, in a day, it's more than enough. But to get to 15 times of Surya Namaskar, you might have to go through at least a month of practice to get there. It also aligns your spine, your brain and spine are aligned, and because we are mostly, you know, on the phone, we're like this, or we have systems wherein we are constantly watching something, there is external radiation that's coming to us. So these are things that are unavoidable in situations like this. All people who work on laptops and phones most of the time, so our neck and spine are generally under a lot of stress. So it's better when we start doing Surya Namaskar, especially our posture improves, we start sitting better, we start feeling better, and we also become more and more flexible, and our stress levels automatically reduce. So we deal with stress in a much better way. And the last and final would be the diet and nutrition. Again, one last thing before that is you should be avoiding all kinds of drug abuse or alcohol or smoking, etc., because these things are unhealthy habits that will deteriorate your immune system. In case you're following any of these habits, then please do try and avoid it. Reduce it bit by bit. It's not like you give up overnight, then you will have withrawal symptoms, which is again not good. You might end up catching another habit, which is not good. So you try reducing it slowly, consciously, over a period of time, and then you'll be able to get over it very easily. So try stay away from all these unhealthy habits, and maintain a healthy weight. That is also one of the reasons why your immune system can go down. If you're overweight or obese, the body's maintenance is very high. It has to take care of a lot of cells in the body. The lesser the cells, it'll focus on constructive activities. So try maintaining a healthy weight as well. And the last and final one is the diet and nutrition. Now, when you're talking about diet and nutrition, it is too vast to cover in an hour, but there are a few things that I would mention which are very, very important for your body. The first and foremost in them are some herbs and spices that can help you. Okay, generally the body requires about 13 vitamins and 11 minerals on a regular basis to perform all its function optimally. Out of this, if you need to get all of these ingredients into your body on an everyday basis, you need to eat 9 different colored fruits and vegetables into your diet, which sometimes might be practically impossible, but then there are few herbs and spices which you can definitely include into your system on a regular basis that can help you in terms of dealing with or building immunity, rather, not dealing with pathogens, but building with immunity. Okay, so some herbs and spices you might have heard of, some might be quite new to you, but then I'll mention all of them and then you'll have someone take over from here on and explain you in detail. Okay, so the first thing I would say is an everyday ingredient that's found in our kitchen, turmeric. Okay, try and find an organic turmeric, include that as a part of your meal every single day. The second ingredient is ginger. This again in India is abundantly available to us and we can use it in you know, decoctions, you can use it in your cooking, in everything that you use. The final one is found in most of the households. It's tulsi. Tulsi is again available to all of us mostly. If not, you get it in the market also very easily. You can make tulsi tea and you can have, or you have other options of having tulsi as well. And some other Ayurvedic ingredients which will really help you. One is ashwagandha. Now, ashwagandha is known to reduce stress for us. And, you know, reducing stress is better sleep. Better sleep is better repair. Better repair is better rejuvenation. So ashwagandha is one of the main ingredients that can help you in the long run. The other two are Brahmi and Muleti. These also you must have heard because there's a lot of, you know, people talking about these things on an everyday basis. The Ayush Ministry talks about it on an everyday basis. So these are things that you can include as a part of your routine. And when it comes to vitamins and minerals, like I said, we need 13 vitamins, 11 minerals on a regular basis. Out of this, a few of them are very, very important. The vitamin C, you know, vitamins, which is comes from your lemons and oranges. They are very important for building immunity. They're rich in antioxidants and they help us. Vitamin A, which comes from all the orange colored vegetables like carrots, and all these things are very important for the body as well. So vitamin A also help in building immunity. And last and final is vitamin E, which comes in the form of nuts and the seeds that we eat, like sunflower seeds, muskmelon seeds, badams, pistas, you know, all these things, which really help our body in terms of getting vitamin E. And then there are certain spices, or I would say superfoods, that help in building immunity. These things can turn over your immunity like in a matter of few days of usage. One is garlic, the other is star anise, or it's also called the chakra fool. You can use that on an everyday basis to build immunity in the long run. And so from here on, I think Jayashree will take over. She is a wellness consultant and she'll give you details on how to smartly include all the ingredients that I mentioned above. So what happens in our day-to-day routine is we are so much, you know, in doing a lot of things that we tend to forget how to include these things. She'll tell you how to smartly get this as a part of your routine. Jayashree, you can take over from here.
Madam, you can share.
Thank you, Anita.
You can share the slides using the share option. If you want to share your slides, you can use the share option. Go to the share screen and you can show the PPT if it is there. If it is not there, you can directly see.
We do have PPTs.
Oh, okay. If you are having, you can use that.
Yes, we do have. So, good evening, everybody. It's so nice to have all of you. Anita, thank you for such a wonderful presentation on the importance of immunity. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
You can say yes. Sin. Yeah. So, I'll have Anita talk to me if that's okay with the others. So, has Anita done a wonderful job in getting us to know the importance of immunity? So you can say yes in the chat box if you wish to. Great. So now, as Anita took you through the four pillars of optimal health, we saw that the other three, which are the correct sleep and rest, which means lack of stress or avoiding stress or managing stress. And she also told us how to exercise, that is structured or unstructured as per each one's body and each one's need. Now, the last part, which was the dietary supplements, is where we are going to pay more attention now. So, is it necessary to have dietary supplements? I think we have gone in detail as to what all we require. So, the challenge would be to get all of them in one day. So, the answer is obviously yes. And not only diet, but whatever essentials we require are not available in our day-to-day life, and they should be supplemented. So, can we go to the next slide, Anita?
Sure.
See, many of you may be teachers, so you know that at school, whatever is taught is not called tuition. So, whatever is done apart from the school teaching is called tuition. So, our supplements are equal to tuition. Now, the next thing that comes up is how to choose supplements. So, now there are two sources. One is the synthetic and the other natural. Now, let us look at the difference between them. So, when we talk of synthetic supplements, obviously they are man-made. And absorption is 8 to 12%. And they do come with side effects, as most of them are in metallic form. And they are made in labs. But when you look at natural supplements, they are made from natural food. Or rather, we get them from natural food. And the absorption obviously is 98%. Because body absorbs plant source easily than any other source. And as such, there will be no side effects. And these are not in metallic form. Can I have the next slide, please?
Sure.
So now comes which company. So we are talking of Nutrilite. And Nutrilite is a leading brand of vitamins, minerals, and dietary supplements created in 1934 by Dr. Carl Rainbow. Nutrilite is also the only global vitamin and minerals brand to grow, harvest, and process plants on its own certified organic farms. There are over 6,000 acres of organic farms certified, and all the supplements that I'm going to talk to you about now are grown and manufactured there. Hence, when we look at why Nutrilite, reason one, they are whole plant. Two, the system of farming is completely organic. And we could go on talking about the system of farming, which will itself take more than 8 hours. So as of now, let me just hint the points to you. And there is natural goodness. And not only that, since they grow in their own certified organic farms, there is total control and ownership of the process. Can we go to the next, please?
Yeah, sure.
Meanwhile, Srinath is raising his hand. You want to ask anything, Srinath? Can you type? We can go to the from protein. We'll go to protein.
From you?
Yeah, protein. APP.
Okay. This is okay?
Okay. Yeah. Yes. Somebody asked, give example of synthetic. So whatever supplement you get from the medical store, for example, are all synthetic. So one of the best examples I could give you is Shelcal. So whenever some doctor prescribes calcium, most of the time it is Shelcal. So Shelcal is a synthetic supplement. So let us look at the first product, which comes in the immunity boosting category. As Anita told us, that all our cells need to be highly, 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 given nutrition and the right nutrition. So what creates cells? So we all know that protein is the building block of the body. So protein is the one which is the first supplement that we require. It is very vital to fight viral and bacterial infection. And there are 9 amino acids which actually our body doesn't make. So we need to take that externally. WHO, through its recommended dietary allowance, tells us that to have a good building block of the body and good blocks of body cells, we need 1 gram per kg of body weight. And that should be replenished every day because protein doesn't get saved or stored. Now, in all plant protein powder, the source is completely plant source, which is yellow peas, wheat, and soya. And the bioavailability is 8 grams per 10 grams of protein. A scoop of 10 grams gives you 8 grams of protein, which is the highest bioavailability today. Not only that, you will see that there is a score called PDCAS. It means protein digestibility corrected amino acid score, which says that it is easy to digest. Can we go to the next slide? Next, what Nutrilite has done is, along with the products which it manufactures, it has tied up with the wisdom of traditional herbs. And particularly today, we are going to look at those traditional herbs which support immunity, which means Nutrilite has tied up with Ayurveda, with the thousands of years of wisdom in India, and they have come up with these products. Next slide, please. So among them, you will see the first and foremost is Nutrilite, Vasaka, Muleti, and Surasa. Now we are now all talking about the current challenge where respiratory discomfort is one of the symptoms. But what I'm going to tell you is not just now, but anytime when anybody has any respiratory issue, what supports them is Vasaka, Muleti, and Surasa. And these herbs also have expectorant and anti-inflammatory benefits. What do you mean by expectorant? Sometimes when there is phlegm collected, you need to bring it out. So this will help in that. That's called expectorant. And herbs known to have immunomodulatory properties and antioxidant. See, when we talk of immunity, obviously we talk of infection. And for fighting against infection, what do you require? Vitamin C. And vitamin C is an antioxidant. So here we are talking of the property of antioxidant present in Vasaka, Muleti, and Surasa. And when you say immunomodulatory, it actually helps in increasing immunity. Next slide, please. The next traditional herb we look at is Tulsi. If you remember, Anita was mentioning that Tulsi also boosts immunity. So Tulsi supports in immunity. It is an adaptogen and a powerful antioxidant again. So you will hear this word antioxidant and you would have heard it enough around these past few months because that is the one which helps fight infection. So if you have enough antioxidants in your body, you can be sure that you have a good army with you. So what is the difference between a Tulsi tablet here and the Tulsi that you can eat at home? Although you can eat Tulsi which you grow at home, what we require may be in concentrate form. And one Tulsi tablet equals 100 dried organic Tulsi leaves extracts. And that too from a hero ingredient. It is the black Tulsi, not the green Tulsi in this. So obviously, when you take one Tulsi tablet, it will give you immunity, which definitely can take care of one day's requirement at least. Next, please. Yeah, let's look at some more supplements to support immunity. Although Nutrilite manufactures many categories of supplements, here we have picked those with support immunity. So for more info on this, you can always connect with us. Can I have the next slide, Anita?
Yeah. Just a minute.
So one of the reasons why we need supplement is also because whatever we need to do in a day, even though we know we have to do, is it possible? Like 13 vitamins and 11 minerals. How will you get all of the things that are the sources for these 13 vitamins and 11 minerals? Exactly, the product which I'm going to talk to you about. Can I have the daily, Anita? Yeah, got it. Thank you. So I was precisely talking about this tablet. So when Anita mentioned that 13 vitamins and 11 minerals are needed in a day, this is also as per recommended dietary allowance of WHO. So how do we get these? So to get these, what all you have to do is a big list. And imagine each, you know, vitamin or mineral is a micronutrient. That means to get a very little quantity, you have to get all of those ingredients. So is it possible? Hence, smartly, you can look at this tablet. As the name goes, it is a multivitamin and multimineral. In this, there is a 40 mg of vitamin C, which is 100% RDA. So during these current months, we have seen that this tablet alone gave us what we required for a day. And not only that, it contains vitamin B6, D and E, among other things. Among the 13 vitamins and 11 minerals, we have the B6, D and E, which are present here in full recommended dietary allowance. That means 100% of it is available here. Then we also have minerals like folate, folic acid, selenium and zinc. They also support immune system. And again, these three are in, as per the RDA, they are 100% of RDA present in this. Not only that, one of the unique features of Nutrilite is that we have phytonutrients present in all the supplements. And hence, phytonutrients' advantage is something which will help fight infection directly. Anita, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah. Because I suddenly saw on the screen, it is Zoom is muted. Okay, please, can I go to the next slide, please? This is a wonderful supplement. It is, in fact, a treatment supplement as well. It's called Echinacea Citrus Concentrate Plus. Now here, there are three herbs, and Echinacea herb is known to support immune health and body's natural resistance. It is organically grown at a Trout Lake Farm. As I said, Nutrilite grows in its own certified farms. One of the farms is Trout Lake Farms. And Echinacea is a herb, and it is known as a traditional medicine. Like we know Tulsi here, everybody in North America and South America would know about Echinacea as a traditional medicine. So this actually works like a treatment supplement as well for those who have bronchitis issues or asthmatic issues. In fact, we have testimonies where people have had a complete shift from how their condition used to be with respect to asthma. So for more details, you can connect with me independently, personally, and I can give you all the info. And here, each serving of three tablets provides 290 mg of Echinacea, and there is a particular discipline in which we take these tablets as well. Next slide, please, Anita. And this is something you would have heard a lot in the past few months. Although all of us knew about vitamin C as an antioxidant and that it helps fight infection, in the younger days, you wouldn't have heard the word antioxidant, maybe, but you definitely would have heard the word to fight infection, take vitamin C. So where do we get it from? So the richest source of vitamin C in India, as we know, generally is connected to orange or citrus fruits. In the interest of time, I'm not asking you the questions and I'm answering myself. So in the world, the richest source of vitamin C is Acerola cherry. And so coming back to RDA, as per WHO, the RDA of vitamin C per day is 40 mg, and each tablet of natural C from Nutrilite gives you that, which means you get 100% of what you require in a day. And Acerola cherry concentrates, again, are from Nutrilite farms. Hence, you know, they are organic and they are completely monitored and owned. The whole process is owned by Nutrilite. Now, how does vitamin C help? Obviously, since it's an antioxidant, it fights against infections. And hence, the more vitamin C you have, the more immunity power you have. And by the way, body does not make or store vitamin C. See, one of the reasons why dietary supplements or supplementation is because many of the nutrients are not made by the body and some of them are not stored as well. Next slide, please. If you remember, Anita mentioned superfood. So let us look at some of the supplements which come under this category. Next slide, please. Garlic. If you remember, Anita did mention garlic too. See, garlic can boost immune function, and many people do not know this. So Nutrilite garlic contains something additional, which is called the allicin, and it is a main ingredient in garlic, which gives all the benefits. So the ingredient known to boost the disease-fighting response of some types of white blood cells in the body when they encounter viruses. So how does garlic help? There is a disease-fighting response which our WBC cells have to have. So garlic actually helps that. And the daily serving of 2 tablets provides 600 mg of garlic powder and 6 mg allicin yield. So this allicin is what is the immunity booster in garlic. Next slide, Anita. So now, having said that, if you remember, we do not have the details of those two herbs which Anita mentioned here, because we focused more on whatever gives the main immunity. But having said that, when we look at the other three pillars of health, if you see, stress is one. So ashwagandha has to be mentioned here, because Nutrilite ashwagandha helps relieve stress. And then we also have Brahmi, which also helps in memory power. And all put together with the three other pillars and the dietary supplements, you can be more prepared, like you have shields in the current times as well as any time in your future. Anita, can I have my video? So can we?
Yeah.
I think slide sharing is over.
Okay.
Or if can we go to the next slide?
Yeah, sure, I can do that.
Yeah. So there are some general tips also, homemade tips. And, you know, some of the things already mentioned by Anita about Surya Namaskara and meditation for 10 minutes. And most importantly, connect with family members and close friends. You know, having very good relationships actually help stress levels come down. Okay. Next, please. Yes, so this is a nice saying by Thomas Carlyle. He who has health has hope, and he who has hope has everything. And we have heard many more, right? Health is wealth, right? So we talked of proactive health, and wish you all a great health and immunity in the current times and as well as in future. I hope whatever information was shared here will give you a new look at your own fit, your own let's say daily routine as well. And with this, thank you. So we are open to questions now.
So thank you, Jayashree, for the wonderful insight on all the supplements and how they help our body. And I think that's one of the smartest way to include a lot of ingredients into our day-to-day routine.
Thank you. So there were some people typing. I think both of us will be able to look at some. Anita, would you like to take this? Any prescription by doctor?
Required to take these? No. So doctors usually prescribe you medicines. These are not medicines. These are something that support your or they bridge the gap between your food and the requirement of the body. So they are not considered medicine. Now, when we say medicine, it is something that's made in the lab to treat a particular disease. But this is a preventive way of looking at things, wherein our body is not going to identify this as a chemical component. But since it's made out of natural ingredients, like it's made of palak, it's made of methi, acerola cherry, all these are like fruits and vegetables that are available to us. So when it goes inside your body, the body is going to identify this as a vegetable or a fruit. And the absorption is complete. And that is why they are much superior compared to the chemical supplementation. So you don't generally require a prescription unless you have a very serious condition wherein if you're on a lot of medications already, then maybe you would want to consult your doctor on that.
There's another question.
So many
options, taking all will be too much.
Okay, I think Deshi, you should answer that.
Yeah, sure. See, one thing here is, these are all the supplements and there are a list of them available in a basket for you. But to start with, one definitely needs to start with the protein powder and vitamin C and the multivitamin. Now, based on particular health condition, we can certainly advise you what to start with, what to add in a period of time, over a period of time, based on your particular health condition. So we can connect on a personal call where we can help you to, you know, handle this. It's a good question. Thank you. So there was another question, Anita. I eat food thrice a day and do exercise. Do I still need supplements?
So it depends on how good food that you're eating, one. Second is, are you really meeting your requirements? So if you sit down and, you know, do a calculation of how much is required by the body and what are all the things that you're eating, you might see there is a difference in that. So sometimes even the food that we eat comes from with a lot of pesticides, insecticides and all of that. So our body's absorbability is also comparatively lower. So in those cases, you might need to take supplements. Now that totally depends from person to person on how much dosage of what is required. So it's better that you get a personal analysis done of your routine, your lifestyle, and then decide on it.
There's another question on a person being diabetic.
I'm a diabetic.
The person wants to know whether
any restrictions on taking these supplements. Definitely not. If you're a diabetic, you all the more need these things because already your digestive system is you know, not performing to the optimal state, wherein either the amount of insulin produced by your pancreas is lesser or the insulin that's produced is not being utilized correctly for various reasons. So it's all the more important for you to take supplements. I hope that answers your question.
As supplements for digestion. See, certainly I could, you know, at the outset mention two supplements to you, but that is not how we would like to answer you. We know that digestion is a major concern today and problems connected with digestive issues is also very common. I personally am a testimony for that. Certainly, we can help you by assessing what exactly is your current intake of food, what items you take and what's your lifestyle. So we will need some more info before we give you that, before we suggest and recommend a supplement to you. But certainly there is, and you can definitely connect to us. Is it available in shops? Satish, good question. They are not available in shops. You can get them through authorized Amway distributors. And even regarding that, I can guide you.
Okay, so garlic and onion are
safe. This question is for you.
Food. Yes, it is definitely, unless you're performing a sadhana, like say if you're someone who is on one meal a day kind of a diet and you are into many hours of meditation, like you do 3-4 hours in the morning, 3-4 hours in the evening kind of a meditation you're doing, then rajasic kind of foods are definitely avoidable for you. But if you're a regular person going to office, coming back, you know, having a family, doing regular activities like anybody else is, then you know, you should be consuming this on a regular basis, if not everyday basis, to keep your immune system good. Onion is a good blood purifier, so you should be consuming that on a regular basis. Again, garlic, depending on your liking and disliking, you can consume in the food form. Otherwise, you have the supplement if you don't like. Like I personally don't like the taste of garlic, so it's better for me to consume a supplement rather than consume garlic just like that. So,
and a good point that Anita brought up about the pungency of the garlic. in neutralized garlic, there is a system whereby the pungency and the odor is not present till it goes into your intestine. So because of that, you won't have that belch or the burp. That is another advantage of that. So having the benefits, yet not having the problem of the smell and the pungency is possible. Also, when you asked about whether they are available in shops, let me tell you why they are not available in stores. The main reason is you saw that there is a need for actually assessing and knowing more about the person before suggesting or recommending anything. Since this can be done only by trained and committed Nutrilite or nutrition consultants, these are not sold off the shelf.
How to improve skin texture through natural foods. And that's a whole topic altogether. So it might take really long, but some quick tips on that. One is increase the amount of vitamin C in your diet. Drink a lot of water, at least 3 to 3.5 liters. Make sure that you have a good skincare routine. You cleanse, you tone, you moisturize your skin well based on your skin type. And what else? Vitamin E rich sources like nuts as a part of your routine, as good oil, good fat into your diet, like coconut oil, ghee as a part of your routine.
And also protein to add,
yeah,
Anita.
Protein, of course.
Because when it comes to skin, because skin needs a lot of protein, you know, most of us are deficient on that. So since protein can actually create those new cells which give that new look and the young look to your skin, you need to add protein to your diet. Also, omega-3 does a very good thing on your skin. The effects are amazing. Yeah, there was another question. I just missed it.
Sorry, I can't see that.
I think it's thanks on garlic point.
Okay.
So I think Satish and Srinath have asked us questions. You may note down our numbers immediately after the session is about to conclude, and we will certainly get back to you. That doesn't mean questions can stop. You can still ask. You're welcome, Srinath. In fact, somebody didn't ask about hair still. So I just thought I'll add that as well. Because 90% of the people in India are protein deficient, you will hear these common cases. Hair issues, skin issues, and of course all the other illnesses which are connected with aging, etc. Because quality cells create quality tissues, and quality tissues create quality organs, and hence the organ system. So if you have quality cells, definitely you will have a very active and healthy life. Yes. As you are aware that for eyes, the supplement we talk of is vitamin A. We certainly have supplements for eye also. As I said, we have many categories of supplements. Today, we spoke about the immunity boosters. We do have for specialized concerns and lifestyle related, for women, for children. So we can get on a one-on-one consultation where we can take you through everything. You can maybe take a screenshot or note our number. We would be very, you know, eager to get in touch with you. You're welcome, Srinath. Are there any more questions? Anita, do you wish to wrap up, say anything to complete the session?
Yeah, sure. So Based on all that we spoke about today on immunity and the ways to build our immunity, I think it's become all the more important in today's day and age, not just for us, but also for the next generation or the younger children in our families who are still, learning to build their immunities or still in the learning curve. So the more we get better in our routines, the more we get better in the way we eat, the more we, imbibe these things into our routine, it becomes easier for them to follow as well. So I would say it's not just for 1 month, 2 months or 3 months that you do things. These are things that you do for the rest of your life to keep yourself safe, your family safe and healthy. And immunity is a long-term process. It's not built overnight. You need to put in effort. You need to put in time to build this. But once you start doing these on a stepwise basis, you will also keep lifestyle diseases coming at a much later stage if you have heredity implications of them. So it's better that you start now and reap the benefits much later. So all the best to all of you. Have a great, I don't know if I should say lockdown, but then have fun and make sure that the lockdown doesn't get to your nerves. Stay healthy and stay safe.
Thank you, madam. Sure.
Thank you.
You, madam.
Thank you all.
Thank you. This video is available on YouTube. We'll post that video. You can share this video wherever you want. So we'll share the link. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We want to thank Raju also and his team for putting all this together. So thank you, Raju and team. And thank you all
thank
the
you.
Attendees.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And thank you, Anita.
Thank
so
you.
We'll be logging out now.
Yeah, you can log.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Anita and Jayashree. Thanks.
Thank you.